welcome to this edition of Alverni University's TV show, What's New at the U. I'm Megan Henze.
And I'm Sam Cornell. And in this show, we'll take a look at some of the highlights of this semester.
During this segment, we will be covering new construction on campus, a unique Hats Off for Cancer event, and a ribbon cutting of a new addition at Angelica Park.
We'll also highlight Alvernia's new media suite and students having fun at Spring Fling.
Our top story today is the expansion at Alvernia. Alvernia is growing and expanding in more ways than one. Starting next semester, it is anticipated that there will be more dorms to accommodate the eager students striving to further their education. Reporter Sarah Hewitt and videographer Christian Penna have the details.
The recent construction is creating commotion on campus. Three new buildings are currently being added to Alvernia University's campus. These include two new resident buildings as well as the Commons. The Commons is a new concept for Alvernia. It will be a building with recreational facilities and a new gym. Vice President of Student Life, Dr. Chikala, is enthusiastic for Alvernia's growth.
Well, you know, it's an exciting time for me to be here as a member of the, you know, the staff and faculty. And I hope it's an exciting time for you to be here as well. We've made really remarkable progress these last 7 years under the leadership of Tom Flynn, Dr. Flynn, our president. He's built a strong team around him, and we with you, you know, that this is very much of a community effort.
Although construction is a positive change to Alvernia's campus, there are some downsides, such as the noise. Some students have concerns about the construction. Charday Willis explains her perspective.
Well, sometimes when I'm trying to walk through certain areas, or when I'm looking to walk like on a silent walk, when I'm walking through campus, I mean, it gets kind of annoying throughout the day to have construction constantly going on, especially even if I want to sit outside and do my homework. So it is kind of tough.
Administration says a little noise is necessary in order for Alvernia to continue to expand.
It's unfortunately a fact of life for a growing institution, and you know, you've all made that possible, and we know that. We work together on making this a good place.
Students like Mary Motes says the noise doesn't bother her.
Not personally. I mean, I hear once in a while, but it's nothing major. I mean, construction's gonna happen no matter where you go, so it's something that just people have to deal with.
The new residence buildings will be done by August, in time for the new fall semester. As for the new commons, the process has been delayed to open by December or January of next year.
The new dorms are called Founders Village. Each building will be named after someone who has impacted Alvernia. In the fall, approximately 1,000 students will be living on campus.
Speaking of making an impact here at Alvernia, students from Alvernia's public relations class held the school's first ever Hats Off for Cancer event.
There was more than just love in the air this past Valentine's Day at Alvernia University. There were hats. 750 brand new children's hats. The first ever Hats Off to Cancer event was held in the Physical Education Center at Alvernia's men's basketball game against Messiah College. All these hats were collected as part of a service learning project by Dr. Jody Radosh's public relations class. The class teamed up with local Girl Scout Troop 1790 from Sinking Spring. The hats will be donated to Penn State Medical Center to children who have cancer. The students are hoping to hold this event next year.
Students of Alvernia's public relations class continued to raise money for pediatric cancer at the event called Lunchtime Lemonade to benefit Alex's lemonade stand.
It was a lunch all about lemons to promote a good cause. Students chalked the campus, inviting all to attend. Thursday, Alvernia students hosted a lemon lunchtime event to create awareness for Alex's lemonade stand.
Our public relations class is kicking off a special event for the Alex's Lemonade Career Seder Walk this Sunday. So we're out here today just having a bunch of lemon games, and we're giving out free lemonade and Alex's Lemonade water ice.
Students help themselves to free lemonade, cookies, and water ice. People made donations by buying paper lemons and tie-dyed yellow bracelets. The lunch was designed to create buzz for the upcoming Alex's Lemonade Stand Walk-In Festival. There was even juggling at this event.
Lunchtime Lemonade had a great turnout and was a huge success for the upcoming event, Alex's Lemonade Cure Seder Walk.
It was great that Alvernia's men's soccer team lent a helping hand to the nonprofit organization Habitat for Humanity. Thanks to these student athletes, the house in downtown Reading was fully restored.
On March 31st, the Alvernia men's soccer team got together to give back to the community by working alongside Habitat for Humanity, a nonprofit group which has built over 500,000 houses and helped over 2.5 million people worldwide. The boys helped make one family's dream of owning their own home come true. Thanks to a little sweat, a lot of fun, and even more teamwork, the boys gave back and helped turn out what was once nothing more than a dream into a blossoming reality.
These steps out for me, because they were crumbling and they were poorly made to begin with.
As many of you noticed, Bernardine Hall has a new addition, a brand new media suite complete with a studio, green screen, and sound room. Here's Stephen Thompson to tell you more.
On March 8th, Alvernia University held an open house to all students and faculty for the grand opening of the new media center. Many students were excited to test out the new technology.
As a communications major, whoever it is, you would want to have access to using computers, having access to use all these great programs, and there is not much you can do if you don't have access to those.
I think the coolest part are the people who work here, because they do things that are like, oh my gosh, you really did that? Holy smokes.
There are over 20 Mac computers for students and faculty, as well as a full sound studio and a TV production room. Make sure to stop by Alvernia's new media center.
We're glad that we have this media suite, or this show would not be possible.
It wouldn't be. This year, we also welcomed another new addition to Bernardine Hall, the Study Abroad office. Here's Rachel Craw with more on this new addition.
Does sipping a café au lait in Paris or savoring a gelato in Rome sound like fun? Then you're in luck, because Alvernia University's new Study Abroad program can help. This year, Alvernia officially teamed up with Arcadia University, outside Philadelphia, to offer study abroad programs in 8 cities throughout the world. Jen Dalton is the new study abroad coordinator on campus.
Students often, when they come to college, and especially after their freshman year, they're really ready to challenge themselves and have some adventure and see the world a little bit. So I feel like it's in a way to get away from the known and find out what you're really made of.
So far, 60 students have expressed interest in studying abroad. If you want to find out more, the Study Abroad office is located on the first floor of Bernardine Hall.
On a lighter note, Alvernia students took some time to have some fun and stepped out of the library and into Burke's Lanes. Students were able to strike and spare a couple of hours of laughs, snacks, and quality time with friends. Bring it.
Fun nights to get away from school, work, things like that. Your mark, ready, set, let's go. Dance floor pro, I know, you know. I go psycho
when my new joint hit. Just can't sit, gotta get jiggy with it. That's it, the honey. It's a great opportunity to come out and hang out with friends. All up in my eyes, you gotta try to bag with a lot of stuff in it. Give it to your friend, let's spin. Everybody looking at me, glancing at the kid. I got you with my friends, and it's very relaxing before class. I'll start back on my day. I just bite it, it's for the look, I don't light it. They'll wait to ammo on the hand, stay off late. Give it up, jiggy, make it feel like foreplay. Yo, my cardio is infinite.
This is probably one of the most underrated things that people don't really know about or take full advantage of, but get to come, get a free night of ball, and get some snacks, and just enjoy yourself.
So, have a good time.
That looked like a lot of fun.
Yeah, it was. I was there, and it was a good time. The Alvernia University Multicultural Office brings important speakers to campus in order to create awareness and inform students about different issues. This was the case this past semester when a speaker on the Holocaust addressed a packed audience in Bernardine Hall. The son of Hilda Gernsheimer, who is a Berks County resident, spoke on his mother's terrifying story.
When things really got bad, the synagogues around Germany were burned. Many businesses, many homes were smashed and burned. One of those things that I knew all my life, but I'm still amazed more and more to think of the bravery of my grandmother to be able to take two of her daughters and put them on a train and send them away completely on their own.
Hilda Gernsheimer was expected to speak, but unfortunately she was not feeling well.
We also had another interesting speaker on campus. A panel of Muslim women came to campus to share their story.
Alvernia University hopes multicultural events will help students come closer together and enable them to have a better understanding of the world around them. In honor of Women's History Month, Muslim women share their experiences and backgrounds. In particular, the Muslim women came to Alvernia to share the meaning of a specific piece of clothing, their veil. Moderator Dr. Tiffina Archie, Director of Recruitment and Retention at Temple University, talked about the different types of veils.
We talked about the burqa and the niqab, which is covering your face, the niqab, and the burqa is your whole face.
President Tom Flynn says events like this one help the campus become a more multicultural place for students.
Over the last couple of years, we've had an informal goal of becoming a center for intercultural dialogue, but that's now becoming formally a goal of the university.
Three local Muslim women also share their traditional Muslim upbringing. The Islamic Center of Reading, along with the university's Multicultural Initiatives Department, help support this event.
Events like this really do expose us to other cultures.
Yeah, it was a great event. This was also the case when Alvernia had a speaker come who met the famed Dalai Lama. Many came to hear Rick Ray speak on his experience of meeting this spiritual leader.
Alvernia students learned more about famed religious leader, the Dalai Lama, at a lecture by the producer of the documentary, 10 Questions for the Dalai Lama.
So I think as the first step, these choice emotions, choice energy emotions, this should be called the Jews.
Speaker Rick Ray came to Alvernia to discuss the documentary he produced and his experience interviewing with the Dalai Lama. By showing clips from his documentary and sharing his personal experiences with the Dalai Lama, Rick Ray really showed a side of the Dalai Lama that we have never seen before.
No, no. A doctor tells you the truth about your condition, never to hurt you, only to make you better. Be a doctor. And every time you leave a room, look back at the room. As you go out, look back. If the lights are still on, you must turn them off. Save the planet. Don't leave the lights on. So, like the most profound as he is and the most practical as he is, you know, tell the truth and turn out the lights. Not bad advice. One more thing about religion I'll say. It was very interesting, and I meant to say this. I wanted to talk to him about evolution because it's a hot topic.
The Dalai Lama says there are 10 values to live by, and my favorite words to live by are let's eat. Some of the best eating was done at the Edible Book Festival. Students, faculty, and staff took their favorite book titles and turned them into edible delights.
From the history of Alvernia University to the nostalgia of your favorite childhood books, the Edible Book Festival delivers a flashback to your favorite stories.
If you've heard of the expression eat your words, then you might have heard about a festival held at Alvernia University which takes that phrase literally. The 5th Annual Edible Book Festival was held in the Franco Library on March 28th. Aspiring book artists and food lovers celebrated their love for their stories they grew up with. Books leapt off the pages into edible delights. Many came out to look at the books and eat the entrees. Among them were The Hunger Games, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, and Roots. During the festival, there was even live music. The band Library Lounge Lizards, comprised of Alvernia faculty and staff, entertained everyone who attended.
Continuing with literature, famous classical author William Shakespeare's tragedy Macbeth came alive on Alvernia's stage during the spring semester production. Reporter Rachel Krall and videographer Chris Wiltsey have the story.
Alvernia's production of William Shakespeare's Macbeth made a bang on campus. This classic tragedy tells the tale of ambition, greed, tyranny, and jealousy. The play focuses on how far a man will go to obtain power.
Hail, King of Scotland!
Hail, King of Scotland!
For the Alvernia students, the play was a challenge on many levels.
But it's a lot of work, there's a lot going on, and you really just need to stay on top of it or you'll get lost and play will kind of consume you.
Alvernia student Jeff Schaefer, who plays Macduff, had some difficult scenes.
The scene where I kill Macbeth, and the scene where I find out that my wife and children were raped and murdered.
Mallory Motz agrees. She played one of the weird sisters.
It was very interesting. I've only done one play here at Alvernia before. Otherwise, I've been stage crew. So it was difficult with not only the language of it all, but the feeling that you have to portray. And because your character is so deep, there's no bottom to a Shakespeare character.
The play consisted of 23 members and lasted an hour and a half. But in this short amount of time, the performers were able to bring Shakespeare's words to life. Although this rendition does highlight the mature aspects of the play.
I felt like we did it pretty well, obviously with the rape scene and the murders. It's intense and people might get nervous about it because they're not used to seeing that on stage. And I think we handled it well because we took it seriously. And when we take it seriously, we hope that you guys take it seriously as well.
One of the suggestive scenes dealt with the weird sisters and their actions toward Macbeth when they gave him a prophecy.
I thought it was interesting because we are in at a collegiate level, so I thought it was appropriate, but it wasn't overboard.
Audience members responded well to the play and overall seemed to enjoy the acting, lighting, staging, and costumes.
Several local high schools came to campus to see the play, and Alvernia student actors Sean Hartman, Rebecca Wisniewski, and Ashley Frankhauser were nominated for the Irene Ryan Scholarship Contest. Shakespeare's legacy lives on in modern poets.
In addition to Shakespeare, Alvernia students were also treated to some poetry on campus. Loretta Marie, who came to Alvernia's Crusader Cafe, to share her poetry.
Spring brought flowers, good weather, and poetry to campus. Spring is often the inspiration for beautiful poems, and this was exactly the case when poet Loretta Marie came to campus. Her heartfelt poetry is designed to inspire women.
I don't have a high-powered job or a fancy house up on a hill. I don't have a Benz or Maserati that's at my disposal to will, but if you ask me who I be, I will tell you. I am perfectly me. And I believe that, you know, you can either sit and soak in your misery, or you can use your situation to help other people.
Many people came out to enjoy her reading in the Crusader Cafe, and the event was organized by Alvernia's Multicultural Initiatives Office.
Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Now, you need to remember that, you know, because you're a star, mommy, so let's...
Her poetry reading was part of the Women's History Month celebrations here on campus. It's time to go to commercial, and then we will be back with more What's New at the U.
Upcoming stories include spotlights on two Alvernia students with very unique talents. We'll have the details coming up. No, it wasn't Family Feud, Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, or even Let's Make a Deal. But Alvernia students did get a chance to play on a game show. Students tested their luck in the game In It to Win It. The fun all happened in the Crusader Cafe at lunchtime.
This game is called In It to Win It, and you gotta be in it to win it.
So
It's been relaxing. It eases the tension in the mood. So, you know, when you're coming from class, and you come play a game, it makes you feel a lot better.
Many students, as well as staff and faculty, took time off on Saturday to give back to the environment. And 100 Alvernia students helped out on Earth Day at various locations all over Berks County.
For the tennis team to be involved in other aspects of the college and Earth Day, we're all trying to save the environment. That's what we're teaching our kids, so it's good to be a role model for that. And it's always good to give back to your community.
Fixing holes in the trail so people, when they're walking, don't get hurt and fall.
I'm putting rocks over here so the water won't come running over here.
It's good to do your part, and the tennis team is here. We're doing our part in the year, but you should think about this in your daily lives.
Well, I have two girls who are 13 and 11, and they do community service at school, but I think it's a great family bonding activity, and I think it's great to show them that it's important to us, and hopefully it'll be important to them as they get older.
Well, the students there are a great help to be able to come in to do a lot of the manual labor that we need to be able to get these larger stones that we put in as a base stone for the trail. We put a smaller three-quarter stone on top as like a sub base, and we put screenings on the top of that to actually create the tread deck that people can walk on and not fly through horses, vehicles and stuff. That's it.
The students at Antietam Park move over 15 tons of rock in order to make a better walking path.
Alvernia students are doing such remarkable things, whether it's helping out with the community or pursuing their career goals. One such student is Rachel Boskov. She is already passionate about pursuing photography. She has been busy on campus taking pictures of many campus and community events, including a local fashion show.
One Alvernia sophomore is getting a chance to see what it's like to take pictures on the catwalk. Alvernia sophomore Rachel Boskov is practicing her photograph skills by shooting a local clothing line. This Alvernia student has a unique talent that she is hoping to make her profession.
I started photographing in middle school or high school. I took my AP photography class, and that's when I discovered that I really love sports photography.
This clothing line is created by Allison Witzinger Shannon, a Seeking Spring woman with an amazing talent and a sense of style.
I hand dye all of the clothing, and then I use my original designs carved out of stamps for the designs all over the clothing.
Rachel hopes to one day be a sports photographer. As for the clothing line, Allison hopes to create more hip clothing to sell to people in the Berks County area.
Rachel Boskov's real passion is sports photography, and she hopes to be a photographer for a professional ice hockey team.
Another Alvernia student who has an interesting job is Junior Bernard. Junior grew up in Haiti, but fled to the United States after the devastating earthquake in 2010. He is now publishing an inspirational book on his life and journey to the U.S. We have his interesting story up next.
The book is called The Survivor. It's a book that is based on sophomore Alvernia student Junior Bernard's unusual life. He grew up in Haiti and overcame poverty. In January 2010, a catastrophic earthquake had killed over 300,000 people and left a million homeless. Junior was almost one of them. It was a horrific experience which he will never forget. Unbelievably, he had two other close encounters with death. Junior spoke about the obstacles he had to overcome to a packed audience in the Crusader Cafe.
This is my book. I just wrote this book, and it's going to be out by the end of the summer. It's called The Survivor. I have survived death three times in my life, and I believe there is a reason for me to be alive today.
The Survivor is expected to come out at the end of summer and will be available on the website eyesonvictory.com, and is expected to be for sale on both Amazon as well as Barnes & Noble.
Alvernia University has a new outdoor classroom in Angelica Park. What's new at the U reporter Harrison Deo has the story.
Angelica Park received a new addition today. What used to be a boathouse is now a newly renovated environmental exploration center. This new facility was a team effort by local businesses and unions along with the City of Reading, Berks Conservancy, and Alvernia University, represented by Dr. Tom Flynn, who spoke on the opportunities this building presents.
For developing an appreciation for our natural environment, an opportunity for children and adults alike. And an opportunity that is especially significant to those of us who serve at a Franciscan university.
Alvernia University biology professors are hoping to use this conservation center next year in teaching classes.
A living laboratory that we'll be able to utilize for both our students and the local community students to be able to get them down and out into nature, learn all about what's out here.
The Holleran Center for Community Engagement plans to use this new environment center for its South Reading Youth Initiative summer campus and after-school program.
The semester can't aim to an end with the favorite annual tradition, Spring Fling. This year, there was plenty of food, fun, and festivities. Sam Cornell has the highlights.
Feel so close to you right now, it's a force field. I wear my heart up on my sleeve like a big deal. Your love pours down on me, surround me like a waterfall. And there's no stopping us right now, I feel so close to you right now.
Kingston performed as part of the Spring Fling Fun to a packed audience in the Physical Education Center. So Sam, it looks like a lot of fun. What would you say is your favorite part?
I would have to say my favorite part was Sean Kingston and the Toilet Bowl Racers. Those were a good time.
It looked pretty fun.
As all good things must come to an end, unfortunately, so does our time with our senior students. They are preparing to graduate, but first, we're able to take part in some senior activities. Reporter Jay Hausdorf and videographer Stefan Thompson, who are both seniors, give us this special goodbye.
Seniors and faculty came together at the event 58 Cheers, which is a way for graduating students to show their appreciation to their favorite professor. Setting.
Give back to our professors that helped us the past 4 years. As far as graduation goes, it's nerve-wracking, but exciting at the same time.
I want to say I'm very happy to be here with the faculty and staff that's been basically there for me throughout my 4 years of Alvernia.
And I'm happy to be here as well. It's really nice to spend some time with faculty and staff that have meant so much to us these past 4 years.
So cheers to 2012, and I'm very excited, and I can't believe I made it 4 years. Woo! Thank you.
For some seniors, one memory they soon won't forget is the Honors Convocation. Seniors were recognized for their academic, athletic, and extracurricular accomplishments. One final event for seniors is Quad 2012, where students get together to compete for prizes and enjoy a day of fun activities.
Man, I'm missing today's Quad 2012. It's my last one. I'm going to do it big for home.
Quad 2012, right here. Senior year with Steph.
Congratulations to the class of 2012.
That about does it for this edition of Alvernia University's What's New at the U. I'm Megan Henze.
And I'm Sam Cornell.
Thank you for joining us and have a great summer.
And congratulations to our senior class of 2012.